So here we have a 3D printed little torque wrench designed to slip at 3-inch pallets, as you see there. The pieces are separate inside here, and we want to see how accurate it is. So we've loosened this bolt. Here we have a regular calibration check torque wrench that is has 5-inch pound increments. So we're going to do our best to take this right up to 5 or maybe just under at 3 and see then if this will turn it any further before this yields. So I'm going to begin by taking this first to up to the best we can to 3-inch pounds of torque. Okay, so that appears to be 3-inch pounds. So we'll now switch over, put our socket on this 3D printed tool. Before we do that though, we want to take a marker, and we're going to put a match mark on here so we can tell if it turns any further than what we've currently achieved. So we put a match mark on here. I don't know if you want to bring the camera in so you can see the silver line, the two dots basically line up there. I'm going to turn it gently. You can see it's turning further. It's making nearly a full rotation. And now it's getting really tight. We'll turn until this yields. All right, that snapped. We'll look at what happened there later. And now, you can see the match marks. Didn't quite make a full rotation, but it turned more than 3/4 of the way. And now let's see what torque it reads before it moves. There, it's just starting to move. And that read at 35 inch pounds. You can see here, 35 inch pounds. So I would say we got far greater than 3-inch pounds. It might be close to 3 foot pounds, but not 3-inch pounds. Here on the tool, you can see it broke the square drive. It did not snap the internal mechanism in the ratchet. It broke the square drive. Thanks for watching.